Tony D'Angelo here, and welcome to my house. Today we have a request for some traditional American meatloaf. As the viewer put it, not an Italian meatloaf, but an Archie Bunker meatloaf. So we're going to make a meatloaf for it. Meatloaf, this is a fun recipe. It's one of thousands of recipes out there, but what I like about this recipe is it's not so basic that it looks like you didn't put any effort in it. It's still got a glaze, and we'll talk about that in a second. We're going to run down the ingredients here, and there's two different sets of ingredients you need because, like I said, we're going to make a glaze for it. So let's take a quick look at our ingredients. Okay, guys, we're going to start out with 2 pounds of lean ground beef or ground chuck or ground sirloin. It doesn't really matter, but lean is the key there. Okay, that's very important. 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper, ground. 1/4 cup of milk. 2 tablespoons of horseradish. 1 cup of dry oats, you know, oatmeal, Quaker oats, that kind of thing. 2 eggs. And 2 teaspoons of salt. And 1 pouch of instant onion soup. I know I don't like to open pouches and things like that, but this instant onion soup does so many things, you have to respect it, okay? In fact, the only thing I've never done with it is make onion soup. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to combine all these ingredients in our large mixing bowl. Wash your hands, guys, first. And then we'll come back and we'll talk about making our glaze. Okay, fellas, the first thing we're going to do is take our 2 eggs, break them into our mixing bowl. Like that, and give them a good stir. Give them a good mix with your whisk. Okay, now we're going to add all our other ingredients except the oatmeal. Pepper, salt, horseradish, milk, Lipton onion soup pouch. You don't need to use Lipton, but I've never tried the other one, so I go with what I know. And we're going to give that a good mix. And then as we're adding the ground beef, we're just going to add in the oatmeal. But you don't want all the oatmeal. You don't want to add the oatmeal right now because it'll be tough to disperse. And we have 1 package of ground beef in there. Second package. Now we're just going to kind of like having the mud run through your fingers when you're a kid. Real gooey. Real cold, too. And now we're just going to start adding in our oatmeal. Probably how a lot of the props for those science fiction movies start out. I would have never guessed there was oatmeal and meatloaf, but you go, you know. So that happens a lot when you're cooking. That's why you write the ingredients down, right? And we'll just dump the rest in there. And mix it up. Okay, once we get this all mixed up, we're going to put it in a loaf pan. Now I use nonstick loaf pans, but I also like to give them just a little spray of the vegetable, like the Pam shortening on. It'll make it come out a little easier, and it makes cleanup a whole lot nicer. Okay, guys, we're back. We put some spray oil in our pan. Now we're going to transfer our meatloaf into the pan there and kind of spread it around evenly. I'll try not to touch it. I'm going to have to anyways, but just kind of kind of mush it down flat. You don't need to beat it down too hard. This is, you know, I really love this the next day in a meatloaf sandwich. All right, we're going to get back to you after I wash my hands again, and we're going to talk about the glaze. All right, gentlemen, we're back. Now, the glaze, what we're going to do is we're going to mix this up, and then we're going to lay it on top of our meatloaf before we throw it in the oven. What we got there is half a cup of red tomato ketchup. Okay, throw that in there. 2 tablespoons of brown sugar. Toss that in there. 2 tablespoons of, you can use any kind of mustard you like. I happen to have French's, so we're using French's today. Yellow mustard, just regular yellow mustard. You could use Dijon, you could use spicy. 2 tablespoons, squeeze that out. Looks like that's getting a little close to empty there. Add that in there. That's not a spoon I'm gonna lick. Ugh. All right, and then we just mix that up with our whisk. When it's mixed up, we're just gonna pour that over top of our meatloaf. That's about what you're looking for texture-wise. Ooh, almost dropped it on the floor. That would be bad. And we'd have to start over. And we're just going to spread that out over top of our meatloaf. Now, we've preheated our oven to 350 degrees. And it'll just, you'll smell it and you'll know it. I'd say about an hour and a quarter. No more than an hour and a half. On a preheated oven. Just kind of trowel it around like you're doing cement. No big deal. All right. We're going to pop this in the oven at 350, preheated, for about an hour and a quarter. Well, guys, that's the sound of our oven being preheated. We're on the center rack. And, oh, we're going to slide our meatloaf in the oven. We're going to set our timer for 1 hour and 15. If you guys worry, because of the magic of TV, we'll be just a second. Okay, guys, that's our timer. So we're going to take this out of the oven and see what we got. Smells pretty good. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Mm-hmm. Genuine all-American meatloaf. Now, gentlemen, let this sit for 5 or 6 minutes before you try and cut it or serve it, because it's just way too hot right now. It's way too fragile. Okay, guys, I really, really appreciate the subscribers and the comments. We can always use some more subscribers, so if you could pass this along, I'd really appreciate it. Any suggestions or requests for cooking, let us know, and we'll do our very best to get them out there for you. But without the feedback, you know, there's no fun to it. So please subscribe and post a comment, and if you'd like to see something cooked here, you just let us know. Thanks a lot, and God bless. And remember, even tough guys can cook.